Hello everyone, welcome to the Geopolitics, your one-stop channel for news on international affairs and strategic issues in English. We are focused on UPSC GS Mains Paper 2, Political Science and IR optional, and all of you must have seen the rise of international affairs and strategic issues related questions in UPSC prelims. Apart from UPSC, we are also focused on defense exams, whether it is written examination of NDA, CDS or CAPF, or their SSV interviews, group discussions, lecturette. So these videos can be relevant for those aspirants too. For all this, we provide relevant, to-the-point, knowledgeable, quality content with free PDF and PPT to help you in a quick revision. So please join the Geopolitics YouTube channel and our social media links. With that message, let's start our today's topic. 100 years from today, in 1921, 10 to 15 peoples met in a small room in Shanghai and contemplated about their country's prospects, status, and other facets of their day-to-day life. They decided to form a party and named it Communist Party of China, CPC. 100 years after, in 1921, this party is world's largest party with more than 95 million members and one of the strongest army of the party itself. Chinese Communist Party have many sets under their belt. On one hand, they have created one of the most modern and prosperous transformation the world has ever seen, and they were a main force behind China becoming the world's second largest GDP and also the workshop of the world. But on the other hand, they have also been charged of creating huge human rights violations, either it's in Xinjiang, Tibet, Inner Mongolia or many other provinces of China. So here in this video, we will know about history, prospects and stages of Chinese Communist Party. Beyond this, we will also know what we India as a country can learn from Chinese Communist Party. So this is going to be a very wonderful and knowledgeable video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed our channel or you are first time viewer, please subscribe our channel, like the video and feel free to comment your experience. These likes, comments and your subscriptions are only motivation we have to bring such quality content for you. So please subscribe and like the video. Alright, so hoping that you would have subscribed, let's talk about the history of Communist Party of China. So Chinese Communist Party was founded exactly 100 years ago on 1st July 1921 by two men, Chen Dixiu and Li Dajiao. If you see earlier history and initial days of Communist Party of China, then it was mainly influenced and get support from then Soviet Union, USSR. CCP claims its origin in May 4th movement. Those who don't know what is May 4th movement, then May 4th movement was basically China's anti-imperialist movement which grew out of student protests in 1919. This May 4th movement enforces Marxism and anarchism among Chinese intellectuals. And most of the Chinese intellectuals started believing in Marxist philosophy and violent means. If we little bit distract ourselves from Chinese Communist Party and go back to the Chinese history, then we will find that all over history, China is mainly ruled by dynasties or cult personalities. In early 1900, Qing dynasty collapses. It was in 1911 and it called Wu Cheng Uprising. And in 1912, Republic of China was established and first president was Dr. Sun Yat-sen. But then after, China again landed in a fragmented war era which was called as Warlords Era, because different regions have different warlords and China became a fragmented land. In 1921, Sun Yat-sen in Guangzhou set up a revolutionary government, but in 1925 he passed away from cancer. And his movement, which used to be called Kuomintang, was taken over by General Chiang Kai-shek. Chiang Kai-shek started consolidating power. Meanwhile, here you must also know that from 1914 onwards, Soviet started to set up a Communist Party in the China for their own reasons. Sun Yat-sen was in collaboration with communists. But when Chiang Kai-shek took over the KMT movement, he started antagonizing communists. So both communist and Chiang Kai-shek started claiming KMT movement. They both claimed themselves as real representative of Sun Yat-sen. So there in 1927, Chinese Civil War begins. In 1934, something significant happened. Chiang Kai-shek led nationalist forces surrounded Chinese Communist Party to a small place. And here Mao Zedong, along with his military, marched from extremely tough terrain all the way to the northwest of China.
This event is quite popular and it's called Long March. It was in 1934. This Long March again gave a new life to Chinese Communist Party. Mao became an undisputed leader of CCP and eventually Mao defeated Chiang Kai-shek and founded People's Republic of China. Chiang Kai-shek flew to an island and established Taiwan there. That time Chinese Communist Party didn't have naval presence, so they couldn't invade that time Taiwan. And from that era to even today, Taiwan exists. China calls it its own territory and always threaten that it will take over this territory at any cost. That's why all the times you must be seeing Chinese invasion threats, China versus Taiwan issue and many other related news. So this was a brief background of Chinese history before PRC, People's Republic China, was founded in 1949. If you want to understand Chinese Communist Party or even modern day China, you can classify the whole time period in four phases. First stage is initial days in 1920s when, inspired from European and Soviet Marxism, revolutionary phase and establishment of Communist Party occurred. The second phase was Mao phase, in which Mao Zedong led the peasant revolution and it also took Chinese Communist Party and established People's Republic of China. The third stage can be called reformist phase. It mainly coincided from 1975 up to 2008 or 2010 era. The main architect of this phase was Deng Xiaoping. And the last stage can be called as SRT phase. Many scholars believe that it started from 2013 when Xi Jinping arrived as the president of China. So we will see each phase one by one. So let's start with very first phase. In 1919, Russian Communist Party decided to assist Chinese Communist Party, and on 1st July 1921, first Congress of Chinese Communist Party held in Shanghai. Thus, after this, two civil revolutions, first from 1922 to 27 and second from 1927 to 1936 occurred. Not only this, after this, Sino-Japanese War from 1937 to 1945 occurred. Interesting thing is that during Sino-Japanese War, Chinese Communist Party and Chiang Kai-shek's KMT, Kuomintang, fought together against Japanese. After this, a last revolution called Third Civil Revolution from 1946 to 49 occurred, in this revolution, Mao Zedong defeated Kuomintang and established People's Republic of China on 1st October 1949 at Tiananmen Square. So this all led to the setup of modern day of People's Republic of China. This era also started to coincide with our second phase, that is Mao phase. Mao became the premier of country until he died in 1976. In 1962, Mao attacked India as he wanted to deflect public attention from thousands of deaths caused due to great famine in China. After Mao Zedong, we can jump to another great personality, and that is Deng Xiaoping. And here you must know that with Deng Xiaoping into our third stage, and that is reformist phase. Deng Xiaoping focused on economy, adopted capitalism element, liberalized the policies, opened up the economy and lured the Western countries. The result is today China is world's second largest GDP. This gives both legitimacy and security to Chinese Communist Party, and thus under Deng's idea of hide your strength and bide your time, China, despite being a communist country, lured the Western countries after the end of Cold War in 1991, and in era of globalization, almost all Western countries hugely invested their manufacturing in China. United States, Japan, Europe, all nations, multinational companies, for cheap labor, stable policies, government support, easy supply chain, shifted almost all their manufacturing to China, which is more or less a case even today. Now in the last leg, let's see SRT phase, which started in 2013. A new man rose to the power of Chinese Communist Party. He was not believer in hiding and biding principles, but according to him, 21st century is Chinese century and it's time for world to recognize it. This man is Xi Jinping. He started projecting Chinese muscles openly, modernizing armed forces, stifling dissent, launching BRI, conquering new technologies, openly taking fight with neighboring countries, South China Sea claims, almost complete takeover of Hong Kong, standoff on Indian border, threat to Japan, Vietnam and others became a new normal. All of this led to belief in China that since China has arrived, the only threat to Chinese Communist Party is current hegemon of the world and superpower of the world, United States. Meanwhile, in United States, Donald Trump became president, and thus a talk of new Cold War between China and US emerged. Closing of consulates, using harsh and tough language, containing each other, has become a new element of China-US relations. The then US Secretary of State under Donald Trump, Mike Pompeo, always used to refer China as Chinese Communist Party. Many scholars believe that since now Chinese Communist Party is in open fight with United States, it will be in real showcase and test of strength and weaknesses of Chinese Communist Party. So this was all from 1921 to 2021 phases of Chinese Communist Party. Now at last, let's see what can India learn from Chinese Communist Party. And if we see in positive sense, then also we can learn many things. The first thing is how to modernize a civilizational state to modern progressive economy in a single generation or in gap of 30 to 40 years. China, which was in 1970s, was exactly equal to the India's GDP. Today, it's almost 5 times of India's GDP. India as a country can surely learn from the success of Chinese Communist Party on this. Beyond this, having a vision for the country is also a way by which India can learn from China. China has already set up its goals for 2049 to take over the world. Such visions defines a clear goal for the country and its institutions to achieve. One of advantages of Chinese Communist Party is that despite being a communist, an inflexible and communist state, it is mostly a meritocratic system. Not on the top, but in the medium to lower level, your merit and your education background matters a lot. Beyond this, if we see the history, then you will find out that Chinese Communist Party is a great learner from the mistakes. It learned many things from the collapse of USSR. And the last thing which we Indians can learn from the Chinese Communist Party is selling narrative. Despite being a communist state, it was able to lure Western countries, and even today it gets a huge amount of investment from Western countries. Now if you see what are the lessons we can learn from the mistakes of Chinese Communist Party, then you must know, despite delivering all the things and becoming world second GDP, even today, Chinese authority are deeply insecure regime. In today, China's internal defense budget is more than its external defense budget. Its vulnerabilities like in Xinjiang, Tibet, Inner Mongolia, and even in Hong Kong can always be seen here and there in the news every day. The other mistakes from which we can learn is its stifling policies. Like, take an example of child policy. Chinese goal of child policy was to contain the rise of population in the China, but in return it has led to a huge demographic disadvantages from China. In Chinese system, there are no checks and balances, but whatever the Chinese Communist Party and its establishment decides, that matters a lot. And the last mistakes from which we can learn is a single approach for all solution. From homogenizing Uyghur Muslims to Tibetan Buddhist, Chinese want everyone to become like their Han population, which is a majority in China. All these policies led to the huge violation of human rights and grave concerns all across the globe. So this was all the advantages, mistakes, history, stages, and all the aspects of Chinese Communist Party. Hoping that you would have learned something with that, it's wrap of this video. Since you have watched this full video, I urge you to please subscribe our channel, like the video, and in comment box, please share your experience. I would welcome all type of comment, suggestion, idea, experience in the comment box. So feel free to comment. With that, it's wrap of this video.
You can get free PDF of this video at our Telegram channel, Geopolitics YouTube, and our Facebook group, Geopolitics YouTube. If you like this video, please consider liking it. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel. We will continue to bring quality content for you. We will meet in our next video. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.